classy style, don't ya? Nights like this, I wish I was with ya. On my turf, roll out the Henry Rux. She like when I hit the receiver. Friend hopping, this is a four-seater. Made a yank straight out the wound, I'm dirt cheetah. Major leaguer, no fatigue. We don't get no henna, we don't get no macarinas. Never gon' throw your back out, tryna work, you need a breather. I need a break.
Won't you get down with me, down with me, down with me? Ooh, you down with me, down with me, down with me? Won't you get down with me, down with me, down with me? Ooh, you down with me, down with me? Hold on. Won't you get down with me, down with me, down with me? Ooh, you down with me, down with me, down with me? Ooh, down with me, down with me, down with me? Ooh, you down.
Tell me who you talking to.
Roll up that Sinatra, fly la mama to the moon. She asked me what's my life path. Told her 55 south to the cab. So many couches I cracked. Shout out Zozo, Dri Dri, and Shout Classy.
Baby, I know you really wanna be my only one, but I need somebody to hold on to the fuck up. Baby, I know you really wanna be my only one, but I need somebody to hold on to the fuck up.
Playoff fever has immersed South Florida as we are at Hard Rock Stadium here in Miami. Tonight we continue with Wild Card Weekend with what should be a great one between the Buffalo Bills and the Miami Dolphins. AFC wild card game. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. First down gets him a yard to the 26.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Off hit as he throws there, incomplete. Chase Claypool, the intended target. And that takes us from second to third down.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tuck roll that they can fall back on anymore.
So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is third and nine. Here's Allen. And they work this well upfield across the 45.
Complete to Chase.
Great way to convert on third down there. 21 yards the play.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. First carry now for Kareem Hunt. And he's across midfield and into Miami territory. Up from his linebacker spot, Deion Jones making the play.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
On second down. It's Hunt, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. They call that a loss of a yard, and things get a little more difficult here, third and five.
And it's third down.
The Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. Allen to throw it. Open man is Michael Thomas. And they move this all the way down to the nine. Last play, they didn't even get back to the line of scrimmage. Now they gain almost 40 yards here. So first and goal, and an opportunity for our first points in this wild card game. Running with Hunt here out of the shotgun. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. A 9-yard touchdown run. And the Bills take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Well, these guys have won three straight ball games and another good start to this one out to the 6-0 lead.
And I've talked with so many different coaches, as have you along the way, and they always talk about winning streaks and the mood of a team and how much easier it is to actually prepare during that time. Guys are sharp, guys are focused, everyone's feeling good, and we're seeing it early in this one.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Oh, a good return up past the 30. And a good return, able to get out across the 35 to the 36.
Take over first and 10 at their own 36-yard line.
Good starting field position for the Dolphins as they have it first and 10 at their 36-yard line. They'll run. This is Jonathan Taylor. And he'll take this one for about four up to the 40.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs. Run some plays, run some clock. Allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
From the 40 now on second down. Jackson got a man open. It's Darren Waller. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. give them 14 on that one and a first down.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it, sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
To throw is Jackson. He'll buy some time right. That's caught inside the 20. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. That's good for 28 yards.
That is definitely what we call on defense an uh-oh play. And what you mean by that is against Lamar Jackson, when you see him out of the pocket, your first thought is, uh-oh, he's going to try and run it. How do I get to him and get him on the ground? And guess what? That didn't happen, and his receivers took advantage.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. And now the Bills are going to stop it as they call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. First and 10, Taylor now. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and 2. Pretty effective run there, and now they can start to smell that end zone.
Pound the rock. Make sure you use your O-line to set the tone of dominance and physicality. And pound the rock.
On second down, it's Taylor. Only about a yard there as he takes it from the 9 to the 8. The good run on first down followed up by a not-so-good run on second down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
An extra defensive back here for the Bills on third down. They'll try and run for the first with Taylor. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the one. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they've got it first. And he takes it into the end zone for the Dolphin touchdown. Punching it in from a yard away. And the Dolphins are an extra point away from tying up this football game. A strong, determined run there, Charles, to get in for 6 points.
This is why it's such a team game, isn't it? And I know that sounds really generic and it sounds almost trite, but the blocks were made up front. Offensive line collected victory at the line of scrimmage and downfield. And how about the finish to the run all the way into the end zone?
Point after by Lambeau, up and good. And we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Bills take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
It's a 6 yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
And he'll be tackled at about the 35.
The ball carrier.
They give him about 4 on the play, but he's marked short, so it'll be 3rd and about the length of the football.
Brings up 3rd and inches.
From the gun, it's Allen. That one is caught by Hunt. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
Kareem Hunt. It's a gain of 20. First down, Bills.
7-7, our score after one.
First quarter, with the score tied 7-7.
So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 46. Out of the gun, they run it with Hunt. They'll get only a couple down to the 44.
The ball carrier.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. Allen. They'll go screen here to Hunt. Flash the stick skills, but didn't get a ton from it. Stopped short of the 35. They get 7 there on the screen. It'll set up a third down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
The Bills on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. The Bills on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd-and-1. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. Throwing now is Allen. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. So it goes as a completed pass, but they lose a full 5 yards. So after a rare misstep on this drive, they'll try to make amends on 2nd and 15. Allen's throw is complete. Fighting through, and he's got space. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. Good yardage after the catch. Is that play good for 30 and a first?
And the Bills' first down.
Here's Hunt. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Kareem Hunt with his 2nd touchdown here in this first half. And the Bills have taken the lead. Not a bad start for him. 2 drives for the offense, 2 rushing TDs.
Almost like he's in the percussion section in the band, isn't it? Got a little oomph, right? Got a little crash, got a little bang. He's got it all as he gets to the end zone. 2nd rushing touchdown, as you noted, on 2 drives. He's off to a terrific start.
Okay, you ready? Wait for it. Ba-dum-tsh. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. On the return, Corey Ballantyne. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
The Dolphins take over 1st and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3 and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Successful start to the drive. 17 yards and moves the sticks.
1st and 10 at the 47-yard line.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for 1st and 10. Back to Taylor on 1st down. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last 2 plays.
Use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They run with Taylor. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
He's taken down at the 33-yard line. A 6-yard pickup brings up second and four.
Two minutes to play here in this first half of the NFL playoffs. Coming up at the half, we remind you that we're going to do what we've done all year. We'll get you down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. Coach will have the lowdown of what's going on here in this wild card weekend as we begin the road to the upcoming Super Bowl. On second down now, it's Taylor. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. 4 plays, 3 first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. It's Jackson under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31. Eric Armstead. Credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of 6. Work to be done here on 2nd and 16 after the sack. Another try after the first down sack. Jackson, oh, looking for Waller, but this is intercepted. Picked off by Byron Murphy. And they will finally get him as he's all the way down near the 40-yard line. And when I looked down, he was kind of shaking his head right after he threw that pass. What did you see?
Well, from a defense's perspective, anytime you have your eyes back towards the quarterback, you're in a position to make a play on the ball, whether it's a big-time play by you or an overthrow by the quarterback. You have a much better opportunity.
Earl Thomas in on the stop. The Bills are going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
Second and 6 at the Dolphins.
From the 38, Allen looking long for Thomas. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Read it well and it's picked. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
At their own.
That was just one of those interceptions from our perspective here. We got a good view at the 50-yard line mid-level that quarterback and receiver were not on the same page.
Just by his reaction, I'm talking about the quarterback, he expected something different from his receiver, whether he expected him to break in, out, deeper, shorter. They'll determine that on the sideline. But bottom line, you could see that he thought he'd be in a different spot, except the defender was not his intended target.
That's complete to his running back, Taylor. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play.
First and 10 at the 32-yard line.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. From the gun, Jackson. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A Miami first down on the 14-yard pickup. Throw out wide to Anderson. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. First catch of this wild card game for a 1,000-yard receiver in the regular season. He's got a first down, too.
The 43-yard line.
They give to Taylor out of the gun. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. Here's Jackson to throw. Able to find Waller. That's complete. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down by a couple of yards as they're able to convert there on 3rd and 1. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So with 2 ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. On the left hash, this from 48 yards. And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. So we're at halftime of this AFC wild card matchup as we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Both teams try to avoid being one and done in these playoffs as we start the second half of this AFC wild card game. Oh, a good looking return setup here. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line.
At their own 35-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to. And if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. Now a throw out to his fullback is complete. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
It's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks, but doesn't matter what you call the position, it's who you put there, and there we saw a completion.
They'll run on first down. Taylor, and he'll be brought down right at midfield after a gain of only a couple.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going, and then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
They run once more with Taylor. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. 11 yards there. First down. He had a really solid first half running the football and picking up where he left off here in the third quarter.
How about the yardage he's piling up right now? This feels like a full game, not just the series that we're watching right now. I know people are screaming, where are the adjustments from halftime on the defensive side of the ball? Sometimes they're just not there. Sometimes you just have to find a way to tackle someone.
On first down, Taylor. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. And now Jackson will look to throw it. Looking for Johnson, and it's intercepted. Xavier Woods with a pick. The 30, 10, and he is going to score. It's a pick six and a Bills touchdown.
They were in a very good position to come up with a go-ahead score there. Really good drive. Instead, it turns into 6 points going the other way. Psychologically, I don't know what that's going to do to them.
So as a coach, you're looking at that as at least a 10-point swing, right? Because they had the field goal in their back pocket.
They certainly did, and you're right. At least a 10-point swing, maybe more.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Valentine to return. And they will wrangle it down a couple yards shy of the 30.
Valentine on the return. The Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And following the pick six, and they... decent field position and throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told him, they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
On second down, it's Taylor. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick. He's been decisive. And he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Give him 12 yards there, and the Dolphins have a first down.
6 yard line.
Here's Taylor. Xavier Woods, the free safety, up to make the tackle.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
On second and nine, Jackson. That's complete to his running back, Evans. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. That catch good for five. It's third down.
Didn't they tell us in our meetings that they needed to account for him on each and every play?
You think a guy of his caliber? So how does a guy like him get that wide open?
That usually means there's a tire breakdown on what the coverage was. Everyone thought they were doing something, and they were supposed to be doing something else. But bottom line is, no matter what, you have to know where he is and cover him on every play.
That one good for 13 and a Dolphin first down. Taylor. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
The tackle made at the 24-yard line. A gain of two. Brings up second and
from the gun, it's Jackson. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Brings up third down and 8 yards to go.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Jackson from the shotgun. And that is incomplete.
Jackson's pass intended for Darren Waller.
And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. He connected on his first, this from 41.
41-yard attempt.
The kick by Lambeau is good. And that will tighten this one up a bit. Now a one-score game at 20-13. So in the end, they had the ball for 10 plays, but the drive gets them 3, not 6.
Is it okay if I give credit to both sides on this one?
Absolutely.
All right, let's start defensively. They hung in there. 10-play drive, but they stiffened when they got close to the goal line, made them kick a field goal. For the offense, 10-play drive. They might be a little disappointed they got a field goal, but they moved the ball down the field with dispatch and came away with points.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. On second and 11 now. Allen. That's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. His first catch of this wild card game, and it's good for a first down. Back at the 43-yard line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
The Bills on third down. A perfect 4-for-4 thus far. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. They're able to convert with a gain of 4 yards.
First down, Buffalo.
On first down, they go right back to Hunt. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
The old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. A 1 yard gain there following the 3 yard pickup on first down. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. William Jackson with a pick. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown.
Touchdown, Dolphins.
Third down, passing down. They throw the extra defensive back in there for a nickel package, and it worked out.
And it's not anything that you would think is just great strategy. It's just that when you have 5 defensive backs on the field and an obvious passing down, it's a lot tougher to complete a pass. And on that play, they completed it just to the wrong team, and it cost them 6 points.
Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. Fitting for what's been a tight ball game. We're all even at 20 now as the kick's away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Bills take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And it's all on the line now, all even in this wild card matchup. Maybe their most important drive of the season coming up right now here, first and 10. Brought down by the cornerback, William Jackson.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front.
because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
His second catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a first down. On the run, this is Hunt. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the lot. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
On second and nine, Allen. And this one's incomplete.
I think someone's going to get him the QB1s here when he gets to the sideline. Already thrown an interception. That one should have been picked. Look, let's just be honest about it. That would be the second person in his ear because he's hearing it in the huddle right now.
Not the start to the game he wanted. Like you said, the pick on the opening drive, second drive, not much better. Allen on third. He throws and he hits the slant route to Thomas. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 16 yards there and the Bills have a first down. Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. On first down, they'll run with Hunt. As he's got this down inside the 40 to the 39. A solid run on first down. Gain of seven leaves him with a second and three.
Brings up second and three.
They'll run again with Hunt. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Now Allen. Gets this to a standout receiver, Thomas. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 16 yards there, and the Bills have a first down.
First down, Bills.
They'll run on first down. It's Hunt. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of two.
Tackle made.
The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as they stop it here with a minute seven remaining. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. They run again with Hunt.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
Third down.
Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. On third down, here's Hunt. And he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first. It's a gain of four there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
We can't be totally sure that that was by design, but we do know that a lot of kickers like the ball in the right hash in order to kick the field goal.
And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Now here's a timeout, as they will indeed call it with 5 seconds to go and a chance with a field goal to win the game. And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left. And now it all rests on the right foot of their kicker. And his kick is indeed good. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. So nothing of importance there, just the season on the line, and he puts it home to likely get him through to the division round.
If you're a fan, you're watching this one with your hands over your eyes. But if you're a kicker, this is what you practice for all season long. And this one was never in doubt.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. They said beginning of the season they wanted to get past the wild card round. Well, they just got past the wild card round.
How about that, being able to put the big check marks up in the locker room, right? Get, you know, get to the wild card game, check, got that done. Win a wild card game, big check. Now you've got to go ahead and set your sights higher. There is a bigger prize out there, and they still have an opportunity.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. From South Florida, good night, everybody.